Hey guys, Michael here from the Daily Note. Today, let's look at an app that's going to kick things up a notch for the Galaxy Note 3 owners and soon the Galaxy Note 2 owners as well. When the Galaxy S5 was announced, I really liked the Selective Focus feature and was already looking forward to the feature to come out on the Galaxy Note 4. Well, it turns out you don't need to wait. You can get that functionality on the Note 3 with a new camera app provided by none other than Google, so let's check it out. So a quick note before I begin, no pun intended, but this camera app by Google requires Android 4.4 KitKat. So at the moment, KitKat is just starting to roll out on the Galaxy Note 2 in France and India. So the Note 2 owners may have to wait a little bit if you are watching this video at the time of its release. So here's the app Google Camera. If you have Android 4.4 KitKat, just give it an install. And let's go outside for a change to test this out. So the feature we want to look at is called Lens Blur. Just swipe to the right and select it. Now what this app wants you to do is have a clear main subject in your photo, preferably at the center. You should be at about 1 to 5 inches from your subject, the closer the better. Just snap the image, and what it wants you to do is tilt your camera upwards while keeping your subject at the center. This means you'll be moving your device up with a slight circular curve. It'll tell you if you did it right. Now that we've taken a good image, let's look at the shot we just took by swiping left and tap on the refocus button. And now you can just tap on something far away to make that in focus. You can't see your subject is now blurred. Or you can focus on your subject and make the background blurred, which is by default. What you're essentially mimicking is what's called DOF, or depth of field effect in photography. What makes this effect so powerful is that it does many things, such as isolating your subject so that your eyes know exactly what your subject is in the photograph. It also turns things behind your subject, such as the sky and the landscape, into a natural blend of colors that becomes more like a watercolored surface rather than remaining as distracting objects in the background. And it also gives your photo a sense of dimension by letting the viewer know exactly where the object is in 3D space. If you want to increase the rate of the blur, you can play with this lever to increase or decrease the level of blur. If you push it too far though, it will start looking unnatural around the edges. Now you will notice that the file you end up with is pretty small. It is 1024 by 768 in resolution, which is less than 1 megapixel. You can, however, increase the resolution 4 times by going to settings and resolution and quality, then set the lens blur quality to high. One catch is that the processing is painfully slow, but the app is well made and it does it in the background even if you accidentally exit the app. Just some additional notes. When browsing through the pictures, you can flick upwards or downwards, which is a neat way to delete your photos you no longer need. It also has a panorama and photo sphere mode, which are redundant to what's on your stock camera app, but it may still be worth a look. Now, as awesome as this camera is, it isn't full featured as the stock camera app. Not all resolutions are available, the shutter is slow to respond, and many of the basic controls for photos and videos are missing. So it's not a replacement for your stock camera app by any means, but this lens blur feature is unique, and although occasionally you may run into a few weird artifacts from time to time, it does the job pretty convincingly.
So that's the end of today's video. If you would like to see more videos outside, please let me know in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more upcoming videos. And as always, thanks for watching.